Hi, I'm Kim. You're watching Kim Wilson TV. My channel is dedicated to helping victims of narcissistic abuse get free and stay free. I think it's one thing that the narcissist is so eagerly inflicting injury on us, so eager to harm us, so willing to absolutely deflate our happiness and replace it with misery. Do they know what they're doing? Yeah, absolutely. They know what they're doing. Nothing is happening by accident. Nothing is left for chance with these things. Everything is going to be absolutely well calculated, well plotted out, very methodical. And this manipulation is really, really well planned by these fiends. So every now and then when they get caught, when the mask slips, when their actions just become so glaring that they're pinned in a corner, why don't they apologize? Why are they unable to recognize the role they're playing in the demise of the relationship, the family, careers? They just seem to be so detached from it that they're not able to associate their own actions to their self. And I want to talk about that today. It didn't matter how horrible the event that Trevor created was, how bad the aftermath was on me. He never apologized, absolutely never apologized. Now, the only thing that could possibly make a scenario like that worse is if the person now tries to turn it on the victim, gaslighting them, name-calling, shaming, humiliating. And of course, we've all been through that, and I went through that to absolutely relentless proportions. It didn't matter how horrible the act was that he committed against me. He never apologized, but always, without fail, turned it on me, blamed me, and made me just feel so much worse than I was already feeling. Now, all that gaslighting and all that mindfuckery and all that blaming for the actions that they commit can really, really take its toll on a victim. As we've talked about in recent videos, this insidious, covert form of abuse actually does cause brain trauma. And if you haven't seen the video about that, I encourage you to take a look. Under that video, there are some links that Deb J provided, and they are links to the work of neuropsychologist Dr. Rhonda Freeman. And I really encourage you to take a look at her work. But back to the topic here. Why can they not apologize? Why are they unable to see they've done something horrible, recognize that they've done something horrible, and apologize versus what they actually do, which is they do something horrible and then make it more horrible by blaming us? It's absolute bullshit. I think the easiest way to explain this is, let's take a look at what Sam Backman has to say about this.
It's not that he pretends that he feels this way, it's that he really feels it. He actually experiences his life as belonging to someone else. He treats his body as though it were a dead weight or an instrument in the service of some entity. His deeds are amoral and not immoral. He cannot be judged for something he did not do, he feels. So the narcissist is one step removed from himself. What he does is done by someone else, by some entity that has taken over him. It's as though the narcissist has been body snatched.
Now, the inspiration for this video today was a comment that I saw this morning. Thank you very much, guys, for all the comments and all the support here at the channel. I really appreciate it. Anyways, the comment said, when they were hoovered, they simply replied, "I've seen that movie and it doesn't end well." Well, isn't that the bloody truth? And I think Sam really reinforces this. The movie we're watching, apparently Night of the Body Snatchers, and no, it doesn't end well. think this is really important because so many of us get hoovered back in looking for closure, looking for that apology, looking for some vindication, and it's never coming. And I think Sam clearly explains that because the narcissist is so far removed from genuine human emotion. They're so far removed from their own personal identity that they really don't see these horrible, horrible things that they're doing as a product of their own behavior. And this is really frightening. I mean, when a person lacks the ability to love, they lack empathy, they lack compassion, they lack the ability to assume personal responsibility for their own actions. I mean, you've got a loose cannon here, a really, really volatile and dangerous entity. I think part of what helps us to grow in life, to become better throughout our lives, to have that desire to be the best person we can be, is the recognition of our shortcomings and faults. You recognize when you've done something wrong, or possibly you could have done it better, and then you actively, well, you recognize it, you don't like that, and you actively become willing to change it, to progress beyond that, to be a better you. When you're not able to identify your own shortcomings, your own misdeeds, I mean, you're nothing more than a loose cannon, an absolute stagnant, dead individual. Growth is part of the human experience. And the way we grow is recognizing a need for growth. If you're unable to recognize that there's something wrong with you, well, you're not going to fix it. And I do believe that's what absolutely solidifies the statement. They're never getting better. They're only getting worse. So certainly the fact that they're unable to recognize the role they play in the demise of their own lives and their own relationships certainly limits their ability to get better. But why are they getting worse? I do believe that they get worse, again, as a result of this. When you keep screwing things up, when you keep fucking things up, and you keep sustaining narcissistic injury after narcissistic injury, we know the smallest thing is like murdering their entire family. I mean, they experience narcissistic injury to such unrealistic proportions. It's a grave, grave injury to them. So they screw up. People leave, they become exposed, narcissistic injury is inflicted. This is absolutely killing them. It's absolutely killing them. They cannot stand the pain and suffering that being exposed causes, but they cannot stop committing acts that do expose them. So they end up in this spin cycle that now puts them almost in hyper overdrive of evil, where now they're just in full swing, just so reactive, so out of control. And this puts victims and targets and survivors in a very, very dangerous situation. I mean, absolutely agreed. Not all narcissists, psychopaths, borderline personality disordered, sociopaths, not all of them become murderers, but all murderers, pretty much all murderers are from the Cluster B group. So the capacity to create unthinkable harm is there. The capacity to just chip away at someone and chip away at them until they become willing to kill themselves is very, very real. These entities and this hive mind, this mindset of insanity is extremely dangerous. Sam himself says that they are occupied by some type of evil entity, that they have been body snatched by some force of evil. This is not something that empaths should be playing with. This is a toy that we need to put down. This is the Chucky doll. And I really hope if you're not free yet, you are actively working on an exit strategy. And if you are free, for the love of God, don't go back. I'm Kim. You're watching Kim Wilson TV. I love you guys lots, and I hope you're having a great narc-free day.